Hi, my name is Totic Patrimonio, and I would like to present you a new course that you will learn here in teachavenue.com, which is entitled An Advanced Financial Management for Cooperatives in the Philippines. This course will aim to provide cooperative members, managers, and leaders with a comprehensive understanding of financial management principles. This is tailored to the context of the cooperatives in the Philippines. The participants will also learn the essential concepts, the tools and strategies to effectively manage finances, enhance financial sustainability, and promote cooperative growth and development. And this course will aim to equip the participants with the knowledge and skills and tools necessary to effectively manage finances and promote sustainable growth in cooperatives. Through the combination of a theoretical concepts and practical applications and maybe some case studies, in this course, the participants will develop a comprehensive understanding of financial management principles that is tailored to the unique context of cooperative institutions. This course will be on a progressive type, which will be given for a duration of 12 weeks. So this will work like a regular course session for 12 weeks, and for each week we will have a 2 to 3 hours per session, but I will upload it here progressively in this course, so you might as well follow every release of the course lesson as we progress. Now, to give you a hindsight over what will be discussed on a weekly basis, we will have for the week one an introduction to cooperative financial management. The cooperative financial management, we will understand the cooperative model in the Philippines, the importance of financial management in cooperative sustainability, and the legal and regulatory framework of cooperative financial management. So that we will study for the week one. And for the week two, we will be tackling about the financial statement analysis. So we will have a 12-week course, but on week two, we are already jumping into the financial management analysis. Because as much as possible, I'd like you to understand on the early stage about the financial statement analysis so that you can apply it directly to your cooperative. Now, under this financial statement analysis section, or this the week or week two, we will have the overview of financial statements, which is the balance sheet, the income statement, the statement of cash flows. You will have the ratio analysis for cooperatives. So, diretso na tayo dito. Ratio analysis for cooperatives, the liquidity, the profitability, the solvency, the efficiency of the cooperative, and the different ratios that we will be tackling to understand how we are going to evaluate a cooperative through the financial indicators. Now, we will also be tackling, as part of each lesson, for week two, which is the interpreting the financial ratios to assess cooperative performance. So, while we study the ratios for cooperative, we will be interpreting the financial ratios and the performance of the cooperative. We will try to assess it. So, so imagine the rest of the course, since we already have the financial statement analysis sa week 2 pa lang. Now, on week 3, I will not have to discuss that in further details na lang sa mga lessons, but the title will have on week 3 the budgeting and forecasting. So, paano tayo mag-budget, ano ang dapat i-budget natin, at ano ang i-forecast natin. So, this week 3, we will be tackling about the budgeting and forecasting. For week 4, we will be having the cash management. Paano ba minamanage ng co-op yung liquidity niya, no? Yung cash flow cycle ng co-op, yung paano ba natin i-strategize, i-optimize yung cash structure natin. Okay. So on week 5, we will be tackling the credit and risk management. So ano yung dapat nating bantayan sa credit management? So ang pag-manage natin sa credit ng ating mga members, at yung pangkalahatang credit portfolio natin, ano ba ang dapat nating bantayan doon? Paano natin i-assess yung credit worthiness ng ating member, no? Paano natin ano yung 5 Cs, kasi ang regular na ano natin, ano yung 5 Cs, no? So mga ganyan na mga topic na i-discuss natin. At saka ano yung role ng insurance, kasi importante yung insurance sa credit management at sa risk management natin as a whole. Now for week 6, we will be tackling about investment management. So ang mga co-op ngayon kasi, maraming multi-purpose cooperative. So how do you manage the different investment that you are undertaking? How do you put that into a consolidated portfolio? How does each business contribute to the total portfolio of the cooperative, of the multi-purpose cooperative? Now, on week 7, we will be tackling about the financial reporting and compliance. So, financial, mga reporting for compliance, lalo na sa Cooperative Development Authority, which is our primary regulatory agency. Okay? So, importante kung ano yung kailangan nating i-report, paano natin i-report, ano yung dapat natin i-emphasize sa report, mga ganon. So, ano yung mga legal and regulatory requirements, ano yung minimum para malaman naman natin. So, ano yung, even sa mga other regulatory agencies, because we are still covered by the LGU for business permits, by the BIR for our taxes. So, ganon yung mangyari dyan. And, in the week 8, we will be having the internal controls and audit. So sa week 8, ano yung importansya ng internal control? Paano natin ma-prevent yung mga possible embezzlement? At saka paano yung pag-design ng effective na internal control para ma-prevent natin yung mga misappropriations. Sa week 9, we will be tackling about the capital management and financing. So, we will understand the capital structure of the cooperative, and if we want to have some financing, kung utang man yung co-op, kung ano yung plano, kailan ba dapat pwedeng umutang, magkano lang ba dapat ang pwedeng iutang, kung kakailanganin talaga, at saka paano natin mababayaran, at saka paano, ano ang gagawin natin kung kailangan talaga natin yun. Okay? Although this will have some relation to the liquidity, and will also have some relation to ano ba yung strategic move ng kooperatiba. Kasi minsan mayroong mga expansion that will be tackled on the week 10, which is financial planning for growth and expansion. Ano ba yung gusto natin sa ating paglago? Ano ba yung ancillary business na gusto nating pasukan? Or are we on the impulse, ano yung magandang business during the time na yan? Or ano yung talagang long term na makikita natin na ano yung dapat nating ipursue based on our existing business ng kooperatiba? Kasi ang normal dyan, para hindi masyadong malayo yung magiging shift ng ng business acumen ng ating mga top management at saka ng ating board, importante na merong connect doon sa original business, yung next business natin. Merong relationship. Okay? So, kasi pag may connect yan, madaling ma-analyze na bakit yan yung business na pinili natin. Dahil meron tayong kaalaman in one way or another sa business na yan, dahil may connection yan dito sa original business natin. Okay? So, ganun. So, number 11 or week 11, we will be tackling about the performance, evaluation, and benchmarking. Ano yung, paano natin pag-evaluate yung cooperative performance? Ano yung key performance indicator na gusto nating ilagay para sa ating kooperatiba kung paano natin i-evaluate ito? Tapos yung ano yung cooperative improvements on the cooperative performance on our performance evaluation. Okay, kung dito sa week 12, the last will be we will have some practical applications, maybe case studies kung paano natin gagawin. Maybe I will have also another another section in the course na para sabihin natin na mga materials na ginagamit natin. So and para hindi na kayo mag-download na lang kayo kung kailanganin ninyo yung file na i-discuss dito sa course na ito. So susundan niyo lang yung course na ito, and I hope that you will also subscribe to my channel, which is T Patrimonio in YouTube. That is my personal channel. And yung Facebook ko, if you want to add me as your friend, Toti Patrimonio yung nakalagay doon. So, thank you very much, and see you in week 1.